I would like to go over my calculus practice quiz for my Patreon on implicit differentiation. And you guys can go down the file. The link is in the description. Make sure you guys try the questions first before you watch the solution. For this one, we have a total of 10 questions, and we'll just be focusing on taking the derivative. It's just the first step. We're not going to simplify anything after that, because this way we can focus on doing the calculus. And of course, if the first step is wrong, there's no reason for us to continue, right? And for this video, you will have to know the derivatives of all the trig functions and also all the rules, the power, product, quotient, and the chain rules. We can talk about the inverse function in another video. And of course, you also need to know the derivative e to the x is e to the x. Okay, here we go. First one, we have sine of x squared plus sine of y squared is equal to 1. Notice the y is not isolated. So implicit differentiation is what we need. I'm going to put down d dx in the front like this to show that we are taking the derivative with respect to x. Okay, this is just a sum of this and that, so we focus on the derivative of the first. The derivative of sine is cosine, and then the input stays the same, and then we have to use the chain rule. Look at the inside, take the derivative of that. The derivative of x squared with respect to x is just 2x. So this part's done. And then I'm going to add this right here. The derivative for sine is again cosine. The input stays, but look inside and take the derivative of that, which is going to be 2y. But y is a function of x. When we take the derivative of y squared, not only the 2y, we also need the dy dx. And this is the chain rule part when we do the implicit differentiation. And lastly, take the derivative of 1, we get 0. That's it. This is the first one. And again, I'm not going to simplify anything. You could, you know, move this to the other side, divide this to both sides. But again, this is the calculus step. Now for the second one, we have just one sine and then x squared plus y squared inside. So of course, the first one and the second one are different. Here we go. Take the derivative of sine, we get cosine, and the input stays the same. Just write it down, x squared plus y squared. And then look inside. And if you're doing the chain rule for the first time, sometimes I tell the students, look at inside just like a box and then just ignore everything else. It has two terms now. When we take the derivative of this, it also has two terms. Derivative of x squared, we have 2x. And then we add the derivative of y squared with respect to x. Well, that's what we did right here. We get 2y, and we multiply dy dx with the 2y, and then we close the parentheses. Make sure you know the dy dx is right next to the 2y, this times that, because this whole thing is the derivative of a y squared with respect to x. So that's it for the second one, and the derivative of 1 is 0, so that's right. They are very different. Now for number 3, we are going to take the derivative with respect to x. Here we go. Notice we have this parentheses, so it's like a box to the third power. So first we use the power rule from the outside, bring the power to the front. So we have 3. And when you write down the answer, do not draw a box, use parentheses. The inside stays the same. And of course, the power goes to the front, minus 1, so we get 2. And then we multiply by the derivative of the inner function. The derivative of 1 is just 0. But the derivative of x squared times y squared, we need the product rule. So, still need to have two terms though. The first part is going to be, we keep the first function, which is x squared, and we multiply by the derivative of the second. Derivative of y squared gives us dy dx. Because again, derivative of y with respect to x, that's the dy dx. And then we add the second function, which is y, times the derivative of the first, which is just 2x. Continue from the right-hand side here, the derivative of x squared, that's just 2x. And then the derivative of negative y to the fourth power, bring the power to the front, and then minus 1 to the power, but the y is a function of x, so we need the dy dx. So just like that. Number 4, take the derivative with respect to x. Okay, x to the third power by itself right here, so it's just 3x squared. And then this right here is 2x squared times y, so we need to use the product rule. This is my first function, I'll keep that. So we add 2x squared times the derivative of the second, so that is dy dx. And then we add the second function times the derivative of the first, which is 4x. And remember, the derivative of 2x squared is just the regular derivative, just 4x. You don't need a dx dx. That's technically 1. dy dx is needed, but dx dx is just 1, so just like that. And then derivative for y to the 4th power, bring the 4 to the front, subtract 1 to the power, and y is a function of x, so we need a dy dx. And the derivative of 12 is 0, so we're done. Number 5, here we go. Firstly, we have x times y to the third power, so we need to use the product rule. Keep the first function, which is x, multiply by the derivative of the second, bring the 3 to the front, so we have 3, subtract 1 to the power, and then the derivative of y is dy dx. And then we add the second function, y to the third power, times the derivative of the first, which is just going to be 1. This right here is the derivative of the first part. And then we have a minus. I'm just going to put down a minus and then a parenthesis for the result of the derivative right here. Again, x to the third power times y, so we need to use the product rule. Keep the first function times the derivative of the second. The derivative of y with respect to x is dy dx. And then we add the second function times the derivative of the first, which is 3x squared. Done. So this right here is that. And later on, if you have to find dy dx, you will have to distribute the negative. So be careful with the sign. And also be careful, on the right hand side, we differentiate x with respect to x. So we get 1. So this is equal to 1. That's it. Now, number 6, take the derivative. The first part is that we have square root. And this is something that you definitely should remember. Note that whenever you differentiate square root of x, you get 1 over 2 square root of x. Definitely remember this. You don't want to write this as x to the 1 half power every single time because it takes too long. You will see square roots a lot. So remember this, it'll be much faster. So when we differentiate square root, we get 1 over 2 times square root of whatever we have inside. So that's 1 plus y squared. And then we look at the inside and take the derivative. Derivative of 1 is 0. Derivative of y squared gives us 2y. And you know it, we need a dy dx. Continue. Derivative of y with respect to x, that is dy dx. Now, this right here is square root of x times sin x. So we need to use the product rule. We keep the first function times the derivative of the second. Derivative of sin x is cosine x. And then we add the second function, which is sin x, times the derivative of the first, which is that, right? 1 over 2 square root of x. So just like this. Number 7. First, we take the derivative of y with respect to x. So we get dy dx. Okay, and then this is equal to, on the right-hand side, we need to use the quotient rule. So let's go ahead and draw a big fraction bar, and then we are going to square the denominator. And then we are going to put on the bottom function first. So that's y minus 3e to the x. And then we are going to multiply by the derivative of the top. It has two terms, so make sure you put down a parenthesis. And then right here, derivative of x is 1 plus 2 is just a constant multiple, just write that. And then we have the derivative of e to the y, which is e to the y Well, we're differentiating this with respect to x. So use the chain rule, multiply by the derivative y with respect to x. So we need dy dx. And then subtract the top function, which is x plus 2e to the y. And we multiply by the derivative of the bottom, which is this right here. Derivative of y is dy dx. And then minus 3e to the x, the derivative is the same thing. So just like that. And I will say this is a very hard one when you want to simplify for dy dx. But again, we're just focusing on doing the derivative. Now, number 8, take the derivative. Okay, tangent of x plus y, the derivative tangent is secant squared. Okay, so start with that. The input stays the same. Now use the chain rule. Notice right here we have two terms. So multiply derivative of x with respect to x is 1. And then the derivative of y with respect to x is dy dx. Just like that. Continue. This is equal to derivative of tangent x is secant square x. And we are done. Finally, the derivative of tangent y, we get secant square y, but y is a function of x. So multiply by dy dx, just like that. Now number 9, take the derivative. Firstly, we have x times secant y, so we need to use the product rule. I will keep the first function, and we multiply by the derivative of the second. Derivative of secant is secant tangent, and we keep the input. So we have secant y times tangent y, and then we multiply by the derivative of y with respect to x. So that's dy dx. Then we add the second function, which is secant y, and we multiply by the derivative of the first, which is just going to be 1. So that's that. And then right here we have a minus, and this again is going to be a product rule situation. So I will keep the first function, which is y, and we multiply by the derivative of the second, and that will be negative sine x. And then we add the second function, which is cosine x, and then we multiply by the derivative of the first, which is dy dx. And then the derivative of 2 is just going to be 0. So that's what we have. Now, for the last one, take the derivative. Firstly, we have x squared times y, so product rule, keep the first function times the derivative of the second, and that will be dy dx. And then we add the second function times the derivative of the first, and that will be 2x. And then for the right hand side, we have e to the something, right? So when we take the derivative of that, it stays first. And then we look at the inside. Just think about this as like a box. We have to take the derivative of the square root of y plus y to the fourth power. Derivative of the square root is 1 over 2 times the square root of the inside. And then we are going to look at the inside again. Take the derivative of that. So yes, two terms, so put down parentheses. Derivative of y is dy dx. And then we add the derivative of y to the fourth power. Bring the 4 to the front, minus 1 to the power, 4y to the third power, and what else do we need? The dy dx right here. Inside of the parentheses with the 4y to the third power, not on the outside. So this is what we have. So as you can see, if you just focus on learning the calculus, taking the derivative, it's not so bad, right? These kind of questions are long, because once you finish the derivative, you will have to spend a lot of time doing the algebra to simplify and isolate the dy dx. But anyways though, hopefully this video helps, especially for the calculus. That's it.